Hey everybody, what's going on? Juan here. Welcome back to the channel. Something that I've always wanted to have ever since I was a little kid was to have my very own arcade machine. I love to go to your timeouts, to your stop and plays, and to be able to put that coin in and just experience that. And yeah, we can all play video games nowadays with our latest consoles. They have a ton of retro games, but it's the psychological aspect of standing in front of the machine, having the screen be glued right up to your face, and you hold that joystick and you push those buttons. But the problem is that if you're like me, you live in an apartment, you really don't have a full-size space for a full-size arcade cabinet. So that's where the Arcade1UP machine came in. This was announced earlier in the year, and when I first found out about it, I was very excited because it was almost finally going to be that chance to have that arcade machine that I wanted to have in my very own home. So in this video, we'll be going over all the details. I'll be talking about what it is, what I liked about it, and what I disliked about the Arcade1UP machine. In this case, I'll be talking about the Street Fighter II machine. This was initially gonna be $400, but Walmart chopped it down by $100. So what ended up happening is that other retailers like GameStop, they also chopped it down by $100 down to $300. And during Black Friday week, many of them dropped it down to as little as $200 and $240. And I was able to get my Arcade1UP machine, the Street Fighter II edition, for $210 with free shipping to Puerto Rico. Two-day shipping, as a matter of fact. So insane. The Arcade1UP machines are three-fourths the size of a traditional arcade machine. So if you're going into this thinking that I'm just going to be standing right in front of it, you're kind of going to be doing this because it is a pretty small machine. You can buy a riser for around $50, and it goes up for a lot more on eBay, and that makes it about a foot taller. But unless you get that, you are going to be sitting down with this machine. And they come with a variety of different options, including a machine packed with Rampage, Gauntlet, Joust, and Defender. We ended up getting the Street Fighter II machine, which comes with Champion, Super, and the new Challengers. There's another one with Galaga and Galaxian, another one with Asteroids, Major Havoc, Tempest, and Lunar Lander, another one with Centipede, Crystal Castles, Missile Command, and Millipede, and there's going to be other ones coming out. There's one with Pac-Man, another one with Final Fight, scheduled to come out in 2019, and although all of the machines are around the same size, the actual button layout is different, because obviously, you don't need as many buttons to play Pac-Man as you would Street Fighter. Street Fighter has the 6 buttons per player, whereas Pac-Man only has the middle joystick. And before we keep going, because I know there's going to be questions about this, people have modified these machines. I may perhaps be in the process of doing that myself, but it's not going to be as easy as, say, you buy a Raspberry Pi, you put the Retro Pi in it, you plug that into your TV. It is possible, but without further ado, let's talk about the Street Fighter II Arcade1UP machine. So the first thing we got to talk about is the assembly process, because the Arcade1UP machines do not come pre-assembled. So they come in a pretty compact box, all things considered, although it is pretty heavy at between 40 to 60 pounds. I'm not sure what it is, but it's pretty heavy, so be careful. But if you've purchased things from IKEA and other places like that, this is not that different. Dare I say, I had less trouble building this than I would building a desk or even this, which I built. And this is from IKEA, actually, because everything is really well detailed. And the way that everything's packaged in, the buttons and the joystick, they all come pre-assembled in the actual part of the arcade machine where those would go in. So you don't have to be putting in each button individually. Same thing with the monitor. The monitor already comes pre-assembled, so it's a matter of just placing it. And now that we've talked about the assembly, let's get to talking about the things that I really liked about the Arcade1UP machine. And the first one has got to be the presentation and how the actual arcade machine looks, because you see all of the details with Capcom, the Arcade1UP machine logo, the Street Fighter II logo, you see the things around the monitor. It looks like an official thing. The second thing I gotta talk about is the fact that the Arcade1UP machine is pretty sturdy, because my main concern going in was, okay, so it's gonna physically look pretty cool, it's gonna look official, but how is it gonna feel? Is it gonna feel wobbly? Like, am I gonna be afraid to break this eventually? But the fact that it is heavy means that you're not gonna really be moving it around a lot, and it's really well built. As you assemble it, it's really on you if something has loose ends, especially with a Street Fighter II game, an arcade fighting game. A lot of movement's gonna be happening, especially if you do two-player, so just be careful with that, because all in all, I have played this for many hours, I've tested it, and it works just fine. The third thing I really liked about the Arcade1UP machine, and one of the main reasons that we ended up getting it, is the monitor that it comes with. As you can see, this is a 4x3 monitor, aka a full screen monitor. Remember that you're getting this to play classic games. You don't need a widescreen monitor. I don't know about you, but I hate it when people stretch classic games. I know some people are fine with it, but I'm not. I'm in the boat where I want the original aspect ratio, please. So the fact that it's 4x3 means that you play this as originally intended. And many people report problems with stuck pixels when they bought their Arcade1UP machine, and admittedly, I was very concerned about that, so the first thing I did, even before I assembled the thing itself, is I put it up right here, I plugged the joystick and everything, I turned on the monitor, and I just looked. I had it like right up in my face, just to try and find any stuck pixels. But fortunately, I did not have that problem. At number four, the thing I have to commend Arcade1UP for is not just how easy it is to assemble, but how easy it is to use. So you see this pretty big, considerably speaking, Arcade1UP machine, and you're like, man, there's gotta be a lot going on behind the scenes. It's pretty much an empty thing with some hardware components behind the monitor. That's where all the games, etc. are. That gets plugged to the joystick and the buttons, and all of that gets hooked up to a power supply, and that's pretty much it. That's why I was able to just test everything out before I even assembled it. So the good thing is that if you're going into this because you're afraid of dabbing into the RetroPie or anything else that requires a lot of components and trial and error, really, it's just a matter of hooking two or three things up, turning it on, and having a pretty good experience. If you look at the front of the machine, there's an on and off switch, pretty self-explanatory. And to the right, you have three volume options. So there's the loud, medium, there's the off. And when you first turn on the machine, you're treated to the pretty cool Arcade1UP logo. And afterwards, you can select the game. And once you select the game, well, you play the game. I sounded like Reggie there for a second. Play the game. At number five, and listen very closely to what I'm about to say, the buttons that the machine comes with are okay. The buttons. I'm not talking about the joystick. That's unfortunately in the things that I disliked about the Arcade1UP machine. But the buttons feel fine, you know? One of my main concerns is that they felt that they were going to feel mushy. Like they weren't going to feel like you're getting that tactile feedback. But you are getting that tactile feedback. I don't know why I'm hitting my palm as hard as I am, because there's no button here, but it feels okay. And number six, we got to talk about the size of the machine, because I know that when they first unveiled it, when people saw that you could play Street Fighter 2 2-player, they were like, okay, so this is less wide than a traditional arcade machine, so it's going to be a little bit uncomfortable. And yeah, the two people can't just be standing right in front of it. You're going to have a bad time. One of the two people either have to make a compromise and go slightly to the side, or you can do this. Have both people just be at a slightly a different angle. And guess what? It works just fine. That's the first thing my wife and I did when we first built the machine. We stood up front and then we went slightly to the side and it was fine. And with Street Fighter, you could be at a slight disadvantage, especially player two, because you're not standing right in front of it, but you get adjusted to it. And if you're getting any of the other ones that have multiple players and you don't have to worry about your Hadoukens or your Shoryukens, you should be just fine. At number seven, I do want to bring up the customer service, because the moment that I hit the purchase button, the first thing I did afterwards was go online just to see what kind of problems people were having with the machine and how the company was handling it. Yeah, the experience was mixed. Some people just said, hey, just give him a call. I did give him a call. It was during the week. It took me like 5 minutes to get a person on the other side of the line, because one of the complaints, in addition to the stuck pixels that I mentioned earlier, is that the arcade panel where the buttons and the joystick are, the graphic, it actually fades away. People were posting pictures of it just washing away completely. It would get easily scratched, and people were saying, well, contact them. They have a couple of things to help you out. One of them is an acrylic panel. It has not arrived as of the recording of this video, but I saw a couple of videos on YouTube, and they would send you an acrylic panel to put over it, and they would also send you not like a sticker, but just a panel that looks exactly as how everything else looks. So it says punch, kick, it has all of the layouts, so you can put that right over it, just in case your original one got scratched up. And at around 10 minutes, they gave me a confirmation number. I spoke to the person. The person was very nice, and the person was real about the fact that, hey, this is a problem that's happening with the arcade machines. You know, they could have been all shady, like, oh, I don't know what's happening there. And in my case, I called because even though it hadn't happened yet, it was pretty much happening with everybody. So I'm like, okay, I would like to call now, before the problem happens later. And the last thing that I liked has got to be the emulation of the machine. Now, I'm not an arcade expert. I casually play arcade games. So somebody could be looking at this video going, Juan, what is your problem? It's totally not accurate. But during my time playing Street Fighter 2, I felt like I was playing Street Fighter 2. I didn't feel unnecessary slowdown. I didn't feel like any colors were off. So the most important thing is that if you're buying this hoping to play the game, you can play the game. So we've talked about the things that I liked about the Arcade1UP machine, and now we're going to talk about the things that were not so great about it, the things that could definitely stand to improve. And the first one, and maybe the deal breaker for many people, the joysticks. I read about this a lot and I was very afraid, but I was like, you know what, people are probably over exaggerating with Street Fighter. It's gonna be fine. I hook everything up. I'm about to play Street Fighter 2. I move to the right as Ryu and I go, oh, remember how I said the buttons didn't feel mushy? Well, the buttons don't, but the joystick sure does. And it feels almost like it's stuck. There's a movement to it, but it's almost like restrictive. I know this is going to be a very weird example, but hear me out and you're going to get what I'm talking about. The joysticks feel like a brand new pair of underwear. Then when you first buy, you put it on, it's very restrictive. It's like the other ones feel better. This is not how I remember it originally being. The thing is that as we kept playing, that didn't change. That did not change. The underwear eventually adapts to your body, but that doesn't. That is terrible. That is awful. It's a Street Fighter 2 game. I tried to do the Hadouken and everything else, and it just wasn't working. And even when I was playing solo, to be like, well, okay, there's not two people standing in front, so I'm just taking all of the space to see how it works. And it felt uncomfortable. Instead of focusing on playing the game, I was focusing on, okay, down, mid-turn, right, that's not working, let me try again. And when you have to focus on the actual mechanics instead of focusing on playing the game, that's a deal breaker. That is a huge deal breaker. And the only reason that I'm not having a heart attack as I record this, because this isn't $50, people. I spent $210, even though it was originally $300, is because I am modifying this. So I knew that was going to go away the moment I bought it, but still, if you're getting this, maybe it's going to be fine for Pac-Man, Final Fight, Galaga, but for Street Fighter, for a fighting game, no. I mentioned at the beginning of the video that they sell an accessory called the riser. What that does is it raises your Arcade1UP machine cabinet by an entire foot. And I also bought that because they had it here in Puerto Rico at Walmart. Apparently, it was very hard to find. Some people are selling it for upwards to $100 on eBay. Don't. Why would you spend $100? But the riser looks good. The problem is that it's $50. It's around $45 to $50 plus tax. I'm like, for something that literally has no function other than to make it taller, come on now, really? I talked about this briefly when I mentioned the customer service, and even though it hasn't happened to me as of yet, the fact that when you go online, it's not one, it's not five, it's not 10 people having the problem where the paint comes off, I'm like, come on guys, really? There's been people that actually strip it apart, they apply a clear coat so it doesn't ruin the graphic, but it prevents it from scratching easily. But the fact that people have to find all of these alternative options just so it looks the way it is intended to look, that's a little bit unreal. And yeah, the fact that they're doing the customer service thing without spending a dime, it doesn't cost you anything. They don't charge you for shipping for the acrylic item. That's fine, but this could have all been prevented. And last and probably least is the fact that this doesn't cost $50. It doesn't cost $100. For context, I have the Sega Classics collection on the PS4 with over 40 games. I have the Capcom Beat 'em Up collection on the Nintendo Switch with over 6 games. That right there for less than $50 has more games than any individual Arcade1UP machine. And I know that this is an official machine, licensing cost and things like that, but to go out of your way to buy one of these arcade machines for 1, 2, 3, or maybe 4 games at $300, $250. At that point, that's when your dreams get shattered because you're like, okay, so I have this huge arcade cabinet. Yeah, it's 3/4 the size. Hey, it still takes up space, although it's pretty comfy. You can see right here in our arcade home office area thing. It works just fine. It's to the left side of our television alongside the consoles, and it really doesn't take up a lot of space, all things considered. Like even just talking specifically about the Street Fighter 2 one. Imagine if they added something like Puzzle Fighter, a Street Fighter Alpha game, just anything else, because you're getting one game. And I know for the Street Fighter 2 purists, it's like, well, you're getting the first one, but you're getting Super. It's still the same game. It is variations of the same game. But if you at least got Super Puzzle Fighter, it's like, okay, so we get the fighting game, but I can take a break from that and play this. There's like the Gem Fighter mini mix thing. I forgot what the name of that one is. But if you had just gone out of your way to give us one, two, three more games of the same franchise, I'm not saying you should have done Street Fighter and Mortal Kombat as a weird example. I'm saying Street Fighter 2, Puzzle Fighter, a Street Fighter Alpha game. There are options. Give us the Street Fighter 2, the movie, the game. I want to place Jean-Claude Van Damme on that thing because when I think of America, I think of Jean-Claude Van Damme on my Arcade1UP cabinet. And I don't have it. I don't have him in there. Let's calm down now. Let's calm down just a little bit because now I'm here to answer the question of, is it worth it? At $400, is it worth it? No. At $300, is it worth it? No. At $200 to $10 to $40, is it worth it? If you're getting this for somebody that always wanted to have an arcade machine at their home, or for a child that's like, you want to have them have that arcade experience because those don't often exist nowadays, then maybe. This is not a must buy. This is not a must avoid. This is a maybe if you have a lot of cash. If you're somebody with money and $200 is nothing for you, get this. But at the same time, there's other options. But this is the legal option. You know what I'm talking about. You know exactly what I'm talking about. This is legal. 100% legal. You're not going to have police come in. You're not going to have Nintendo come sue you because you bought an Arcade1UP machine. And if you're looking for more information about the Arcade1UP machine, do yourself a favor, search for ETA Prime Arcade1UP on YouTube. That guy has done a stripped down video, showing every little component about this arcade machine. He's modified to put a Pandora's box. He's modified it to put in a Raspberry Pi with RetroPie installed. And he's one of the people that persuaded me to really go out and get it. He's the person, because of him, I really knew about this. So check that channel out. Please subscribe to him. I can't say enough good things about that channel. So hopefully you enjoyed this Arcade1UP Machine Street Fighter 2 Arcade Cabinet HD Edition. Well, this is HD. That's not a review right here on the channel. If you like this video, please hit that subscribe button. That really goes a long way to helping me grow the channel. You can hit that thumbs up. And this is my last video for 2018. So I really just want to take a quick second and thank each and every one of you that's commented, hey, why doesn't this channel have more subscribers? Or hey, you should do this. Or hey, I really enjoyed the video. I do these videos because I have fun, because I'm passionate about video games. Video games helped me at a really dark time in my life where I was very isolated. And if anything, one of the reasons that I got the Arcade1UP machine was because when I was a kid and I was very depressed, my getaway was the arcades, and I would go and play all of these awesome games. So now we have that at home. So just thank you so much, and I'm very excited for what's to come in 2019. Stay tuned to a channel update because there's going to be some changes, and not for the worse. Hopefully it's going to be for the better. I think you guys are going to be very happy about that if you keep an open mind. I want to bring more entertainment, more content for each and every one of you. So be on the lookout for that in early January. So up until next time, thank you for watching and supporting. And never forget, folks, that this journey with the Arcade1UP machine has concluded, but the epic journey does continue because I'm going to be doing things to it. I'm gonna do things to you. So thanks for watching, gang. Take care. It's been a chore. I'll get to talking about the modifications in its own video, but there's been some problems.